Morning class, we would be dealing with the next chapter, which is environment policies and practices. Here you would discuss about different phenomena like climate change, acid rain, global warming, etc. So let's start off with the first one, and then you'll learn about international agreements, certain environmental acts which is followed in our country, because every country has realized the need for environmental protection. So let's start. Climate change. When there is a change in your factors such as global temperature, precipitation, your water level, etc., over a period of time, say maybe few 20 or 30 years, or maybe during a shorter period of time, we call it as climate change. Is it clear to you? So when there's a gradual increase in your temperature because of these factors, we call it as climate change. Okay. Now, climate change can be caused by man-made factors and also natural factors. Man-made factors, you can see it in two ways. First one is called greenhouse effect. What do you mean by greenhouse effect? Greenhouse effect is where your temperature, okay, around the Earth's surface starts increasing because of certain gases. Greenhouse effects is caused by gases which, such as your carbon dioxide, methane, water vapor, nitrous oxide. Now, what do these gases do? They are released from different sources. For example, carbon dioxide is released from fossil fuels, water vapor, like how we learned in the water cycle, from the rivers, oceans, and seas. Then we have, methane, which is released from animals. Then many other gases which are released from certain sources, nitrous oxide from fertilizers, etc. So when these are released and they form a huge layer around the Earth's surface, okay, when they are very much concentrated, it kind of creates like, you know, it's created like a fort, like how you had different forts around your kingdom earlier, you know, ancient time, no, a few years back. So in the few centuries back, in the same way, these gases form a layer. Okay, now heat is released from the Earth's surface like every now and then. All those heat waves are supposed, what we intend for them to do is they are supposed to be released and pass through the atmospheric layer into outer space so that it is absorbed by outer space. But what do these gases do? They do not allow these heat waves to go from the Earth's surface to outer space. They create a block. Second thing what they do is, we have sun and various other planets and asteroids and whatever, which emit a lot of ultraviolet rays and infrared rays. These are supposed to hit on the atmospheric zone and goes back into outer space. They're supposed to be reflected back to outer space. But what happens? Your gases are in a way which absorbs all these ultraviolet rays. As a result, all of these rays are trapped there. That is why people have, you know, skin diseases, because these ultraviolet rays are being trapped by the greenhouse gases, and humans and the environment have to bear with the destruction. Or, you know, so for example, skin cancers are caused. Then this also leads to something called as ozone hole depletion. So all these are the outcomes of greenhouse gases. So greenhouse gas is one such cause, which is due to a greenhouse effect, is due to the concentration of greenhouse gases, which do not let heat waves pass from the Earth to outer space, and any ultraviolet rays are not reflected back into outer space because these are absorbed by the greenhouse gases. I hope it is clear. Now, there are certain effects, and also we skipped out on this. We have certain natural factors, like man-made. We have natural factors, and before I do that, also greenhouse gases, you need to know that there are different gases which are, you know, sourced out from different things. For example, we have water vapor, which is the most abundant greenhouse gas, which is not being let out to go outside the atmospheric layer because of these concentration. So those are also there. We have carbon dioxide, which is released from vehicles and fossil fuels when they are burnt. Carbon dioxide and carbon monoxide is released. Methane from livestock and nitrous oxide from fertilizers. Okay, so all these are the prominent gases which are there. Now, what are the natural things? For example, we have volcanic eruptions. Okay, a lot of smog and dust particles is being released to the environment. Okay, when the area, we have a lot of volcanoes which are active and dormant on Earth. So when they erupt and they, you know, produce a lot of heat and gases, those are there in that area for a very long time, which means to say people who reside these near these areas have to, you know, undergo the different ill effect of this concentration of these gases. Okay, then you have ocean currents. We have the equator, which is called the tropic area, and we have the two poles, the polar region. Okay, normal circumstance, what happens is warm water, okay, from the equator will go to the polar region and they'll turn cold because of the ice present there. Okay, and cold water from the polar region will come to your equator and become warm near the equator. This is your general natural process. But because of climate change, what happens is the cold, the warm water, okay, which was supposed to be there near the equator, it turns cold because of the climate change. And it goes on top. It goes to the polar region and it turns to be warm water. Okay, normally it's supposed to be cold water to warm water and warm water to cold water. But here, cold water is found on the equator. When they go near the polar region, it turns warm. When it turns warm, what happens? The ice caps and the glaciers start melting. So this is one of the main causes as to why you have different climate changes. Then you have orbital changes. Now the Earth moves around in an orbit, right? It's like almost like a fixed orbit. So here, the Earth is known to tilt. Okay, if it tilts in a increased proportion, what happens is your summers turn out to be very warm and your winters are very much cool. Okay, but if the Earth tilts in a lesser proportion, your summers become a bit cool and the winters turn out to be warm. So these are the changes which is caused by orbital movement of the Earth. Now, ocean currents, again, like how I mentioned, solar radiation such as UV rays and infrared rays and various other rays are being trapped in. This causes a huge climatic change. Okay, then these are the effects on agriculture. We have deforestation. So for example, when there is no forest cover, if you are walking on a playground, you know, you're playing around, playing say in a playground, and then you want to take some rest. Okay, if you find the shade of a good tree, you don't mind sitting there and taking rest because it offers you shade, a bit of coolness and all that, even though it is very sunny. Okay, but suppose you don't have the tree, the entire land is just left like that, no forest cover, then you would have no place to, you know, take rest. So that is where you need to understand that forest cover is very much important. Another thing is, if forest cover is not there for in like say one piece of land for a very long time, that land would turn out to be of no use. It would turn barren. Nothing else can be grown there. Okay, so forest cover should be present, in which deforestation should not happen because it involves the cutting of trees. Chemical applications. We studied about one gas, which is nitrous oxide, which is released from fertilizers. So when fertilizers, insecticides or pesticides or fungicides are being used for agriculture, they mix up with the soil and they produce nitrous oxide. Okay, as a result of which, this nitrous oxide, which is the greenhouse effect, gets accumulated in the atmosphere and it alters the climate change. So if you didn't use the chemical fertilizers from start, this thing would have happened. And now, since we are facing climate change and your plants and crops are not growing on time, we have to again use the fertilizer. So this effect is like reverse, almost like a cyclical process. You use it, the issue is caused, but even when you have the climate change issue happening, still for your crops to perform better, you add further fertilizers. So this causes an effect on the agriculture. And the third one is land use patterns. For example, one area, for example, Belandur, if suppose I'm planning to grow cactus, it's just an example, okay, please don't mind. Earlier, maybe Belandur had a very hot climate, so it was very easy to engage in planting a lot of cactus and growing them. But later, because of the climate change, Belandur has turned out to be a bit cold, for example. So what happens? I have to go for another some other place to have my agriculture of cactus, in order to start my agriculture. So what happens? Every other land which was initially not used for agriculture, which is your non-agricultural land, needs to be converted into agricultural land, because farmers find it difficult to grow things when climate has changed in that particular area. I hope you understand. Climate change is very much relevant. Bangalore used to have this mild climate, but now we have extremes. Now January, February is no longer cold. We actually find very hot, very warm. So all these can be widely seen in and around. Now, what are the effects of humans? Just hold on. These are your general effects on humans. First one, infectious diseases. So infectious diseases such as, for example, suppose the breeding of mosquitoes, which cause say malaria, filaria and all of them, are supposed to breed during the month of August, September. But because of climate change, they cannot breed at that time. They move on to November, December. So normally we feel like, okay, we'll get malaria only during August, September, not November, December. But since climate has changed and their breeding pattern has also changed, we can actually expect cholera, typhoid and all to happen, and malaria, filaria to happen during November, December. So it is happening at a time when we don't expect it. So this is one effect on human health. People tend to fall very sick, and it can be directly attributed to climate change. Then in the second picture, you have this girl who is having a mask. What it means to say is, because heat is trapped by the greenhouse gases in the atmosphere, it does not allow it to pass through, the temperature in the earth starts building up. Okay, this causes a lot of temperature issues. Small children would be subject to, and adults also would be subject to, sunburns. They start falling sick, they develop allergies, respiratory issues, asthma and all that. That is where climate change can be widely seen as a huge effect on humans. The third one is extreme weather conditions. This has a human aspect to it, but more of a flora and fauna aspect to it. So what it means to say is, because of extreme weather conditions, forest fires are caused. For example, your Australian bushfire, various other fires maybe in Amazon and many other areas. Okay, the Amazon rainforest and many other areas. So when these are caused, what happens? Forest, because of the high temperature, they burn. And when you talk about forest, we are not talking about a small piece of land. We are talking about acres and acres of land. So when that is being burnt, the habitat of many plants and animals is lost. For instance, in the Australian bushfire, a lot of plants, a lot of animals lost their life, and plants too. Okay, and some of them have had to move about. There were houses which were near these forests. They got burnt. People were left with no homes. They turned out to be homeless. So all these are the long-term effects of climate change. And finally, the air quality. So because of these heat waves and many other, temperature issues, dust particles in the earth, the presence of these extreme, gases, greenhouse gases, this causes an effect of air quality. For example, your Delhi. Not only because of the pollution, yes, because of the pollution and all those gases released, this has been very much, the concentration of these gases has increased in places like Delhi, wherein people find it very difficult to breathe. So all these are widely seen across the world. Very soon, all the cities are going to suffer from this. So air quality, your health, everything is being compromised. Okay. The next topic is global warming. Now from climate change, we are going to go to global warming. Global warming is where, due to the presence of greenhouse gases, and which is also called as the greenhouse effect because of the concentration of these gases, and when heat waves or heat energy is not allowed to pass from the Earth's surface to outer space, and the Earth gets warmed up, like in a gradual process, we call it as global warming. So global warming is a gradual increase in the overall temperature, okay? And this can be attributed to the greenhouse effects caused by increased level of carbon dioxide, fluorocarbons and other pollutants. So because of the concentration of these gases, when there's a gradual increase, when your Earth starts warming up, the temperature starts increasing, we call it as global warming. Now what is a greenhouse gas? It is any compound which blocks the heat from being released and also absorbs the ultraviolet radiation. We call such a gas to be as greenhouse effect. Greenhouse effect can be carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide, chlorofluorocarbons, water vapor, etc. Water vapor is the most abundant greenhouse gas. Okay, so when all these are released, all right, and there is a huge concentration of these gases, we call it as a greenhouse effect, and because of this effect, the Earth starts warming up because heat is not allowed to pass from the Earth's surface to outer space. It's being blocked. So this increases the temperature of the Earth. Now, there are certain causes of greenhouse gases, especially the certain causes of global warming, mainly attributed to greenhouse gases, such as because of fossil fuel burning and from gasoline burning, you have carbon dioxide and carbon monoxide and various other gases being released out. You have methane being released from livestock. We have deforestation. You have use of chemical fertilizers. So from all these causes, you have to understand causes for climate change as well as global warming is very much similar. Then, what is the general effect, okay, on agriculture? You have loss of vegetation, loss of forest land, and many other things. And also, when heat is increasing around the Earth, the ice caps and the glaciers start melting, okay, which means ice is melting and they add on to the water, they add on to the oceans and seas, okay. If this is the case, many countries which are mostly island nations would face submergence or a danger of them being underwater over a period of time. Places like Maldives, Mauritius, and even Andaman Nicobar Islands are all facing this issue of submergence because the ice caps are melting on a very alarming rate, as a result of which these continents might face a huge danger of submergence. So it is very important also sometime in the future to relocate these people who are residing in these islands to a safer location, as a result of which they might even lose their home. Okay, now we have extinction. Extinction in the process wherein, when the flora and fauna can no longer live in their original habitat, there's a decline in their population, or they cannot bear the heat, and if they cannot move to some other place to protect themselves, they die there itself. So this causes extinction. Many of the species have been extincted from the same reason, have faced extinction for the same reason. For example, if you watch the movies like that Continental Drift, Ice Age 1, 2, 3, whatever, you find that many animals have to be displaced because of the sudden climate change. So that is one movie for your reference. Then you have coral reef. You find coral reefs near the like places like the Great Barrier Reef near Australia. Now these are a beauty. They have this inner beauty in them. You go through pictures, you can actually feel the essence of that beauty. So those ecosystem which has a coral reef is extremely beautiful. Okay, and also you have organisms staying in these coral reef. Now what happens is, because of global warming, all these coral reefs starts bleaching. There is white precipitation formed on these, as a result of which it slowly starts decaying. Okay, when it starts decaying, the beauty is lost, but also the home of many organisms is also lost. Therefore, you can see this effect on agriculture for coral reef. And there is also crop failure. Because of global warming, the crop which you expect by, say, August might not be there in August. You have to maybe wait till December. Okay? So these are the certain challenges faced by farmers and many other people in terms of agriculture and environment. And effect on human beings. How are human beings affected because of this? Because we end up with the same issues which we face with climate change. We have air quality issues, we have infectious disease, we have respiratory problems. All this is due to the high temperature, which is increasing day by day because of global warming. So these points, climate change and global warming, is very much related. Go through the slides. See if you have any questions. If you have questions, please revert it back. Please solve the MCQs after the slide. Okay? Thank you.